In this video, I will be teaching you differentiation of inverse trigonometrical function. This is my third video on differentiation of inverse trigonometrical function. Before watching this video, I suggest that you please watch the previous two videos so that this becomes much more clear. In this video, I will be using the differentiation. First, we will simplify by substitution and then we will differentiate the expression. Means simplification by substitution is simple. First of all, the expression we will correlate with the standard results. For this, you should be knowing the standard results, like sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta, as well as it is equal to 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. Same way for cos 2 theta, we have 4 results. For tan 2 theta, we have 1 result. Similarly, please remember the results for sine 3 theta, cos 3 theta and tan 3 theta. If we have find dy by dx, if y is equal to sine inverse 2x root 1 minus x square, and the condition is x is in between minus 1 by root 2 to 1 by root 2. In this, if I just correlate the expression, this comes out as 2 sine theta cos theta. So I can take x as sine theta as well as I can take x as cos theta. So first of all, if I start with x as cos sine theta, the expression comes out as sine inverse 2 sine theta root of 1 minus sine square theta, that gives you cos theta. So this is equal to sine inverse sine 2 theta. Now this expression I can write as 2 theta only when the result says sine inverse sine theta is equal to theta if theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So let me check whether this 2 theta is lying in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 or not. The condition given to us was minus 1 by root 2 less than x is less than 1 by root 2. I have substituted x as sine theta. So this means sine theta is in between 1 by root 2 to 1 minus 1 by root 2. This implies that it is in between minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. But I want the range for 2 theta. So 2 theta is, I'm multiplying it with 2. It gives you minus pi by 2 is less than my 2 theta is less than pi by 2. So that means 2 theta satisfies the condition. So I can very easily write this as 2 theta. So y comes out as 2 and this gives you sine inverse x back. And the derivative of this expression is 2 as it is, sine inverse x derivative is 1 upon root 1 minus x square. So now I have find dy by dx if y is equal to sine inverse 2x root 1 minus x square, but the condition on x is that x lies in between 1 upon root 2 to 1. So we substitute, I can substitute x as sine theta as well as cos theta, both I can substitute. Let us try with x is equal to cos theta. If I substitute x as cos theta, I get y is equal to sine inverse 2 cos theta, and this is 1 minus cos square theta gives you sine theta. This is equal to sine inverse sine 2 theta. This in turn will give you 2 theta only when 2 theta lies in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Because the result is sine inverse sine theta is theta only when theta is in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So that means this 2 theta condition is on this 2 theta. So now let us come to the original question. The condition 1 upon root 2 is less than sine cos theta. We have substituted cos theta. This implies cos is 1 by root 2 at pi by 4. Pi by 4 is less than theta is less than. I have to take minus pi by 4 because this is giving me 0. At minus pi by 4 also cos is 1 by root 2. So this implies I want for 2 theta minus pi by 2 is less than 2 theta is less than 0. So that means my 2 theta is lying in between minus pi by 2 to 0. That means it satisfies the condition. So this gives you, this is equal to 2 theta, that means 2 cos inverse x. Now the derivative dy by dx comes out as minus 2 upon root of 1 minus x square. Suppose in this question, I would have substituted x as sine theta. Suppose I started with this, x is equal to sine theta. Then you know this is very clearly 2 sine theta cos theta. This gives you sine 2 theta. So y coming out as sine inverse sine 2 theta. But this 2 theta condition is on this 2 theta. So let me see the conditions. The condition says 1 upon root 2 less than x is less than 1. So in place of x, if I substitute sine theta, I get this thing. Sine theta is in between 1 by root 2 and 1. That means theta is in between pi by 4 to pi by 2. But I want condition on 2 theta, so I am multiplying it with 2 theta. If I multiply it with 2 theta, I get pi by 2 is less than 2 theta is less than pi. So that means 2 theta is in between pi by 2 to pi. So I cannot cancel this sine inverse and sine, because this says that theta should be in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Here it is coming out as pi by 2 to pi. Therefore, this is not valid. Therefore, I cannot substitute x as sine theta when this condition is given to you. You have to substitute x as cos theta. Y is equal to sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube, and the condition on x is this. If I see carefully, the result is correlated with sine 3 theta. 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. So I substitute x as sine theta. If I substitute x as sine theta, I get this as sine inverse 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. This in turn gives me sine inverse sine 3 theta. Now this sine inverse sine will get cancelled out only when this 3 theta lies in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So now let us come to the condition. This says minus half less than or equal to sine theta is less than or equal to half. This implies half means pi by 6. Less than or equal to sine theta. Theta is in between pi by 6 to minus pi by 6 to pi by 6. But I want for 3 theta, I am multiplying it with 3. So this gives you minus pi by 2 less than or equal to 3 theta is less than or equal to pi by 2. So that means the condition is being satisfied by 3 theta. So I can write this as 3 theta. That means in turn 3 sine inverse x. And now the derivative dy by dx gives you 3 as it is into 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Now if I have y is equal to sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square within this range, so I substitute, if I see carefully, sine inverse is there, so I come to sine 2 theta, sine's formula, and if I see, if I correlate, then it is satisfying this result. If in place of x, I substitute tan theta. So if I substitute x as tan theta, I get y is equal to sine inverse 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, which in turn is giving me sine inverse sine 2 theta. Again, the restriction, I can cancel it only when 2 theta lies in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So now let us come to this condition. It says minus 1 is less than or equal to tan theta is less than or equal to 1. Tan theta lying in between minus 1 and 1 says that theta is lying in between minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. But I want the condition on 2 theta, so I multiply it with 2. So this gives me minus pi by 2 less than or equal to 2 theta is less than or equal to pi by 2. That means 2 theta is in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Therefore, I can cancel this out, and this leaves 2 theta. And which in turn gives me back as 2 tan inverse x. Now the derivative dy by dx is 2 as it is. Tan inverse x derivative is 1 upon 1 plus x square. So y is equal to cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. I have to correlate it with some standard result. The standard result is 1 minus x square. I can see here it is 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So in place of x, I am substituting tan theta. So if in place of x, I substitute tan theta, I get y is equal to cos inverse 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, which in turn gives me cos 2 theta. So this is equal to cos inverse cos 2 theta. Now cos inverse cos theta gives me theta only when theta lies in between 0 and pi. So I have to see whether I can cancel it or not. So this gives me 0 less than tan theta less than 1. If tan theta is in between 0 and 1, that means theta is in between 0 and pi by 4. So this gives me pi by 4, but I want the condition for 2 theta, so I multiply it with 2. So this is giving me pi by 2. So that means my 2 theta is in between 0 and pi by 2, which is clearly within this 0 to pi. So that means I can cancel it. So this gives me 2 theta, which in turn gives me back as 2 tan inverse x. Now the derivative dy by dx comes out as dy by dx is equal to 2 upon 1 plus x square. If the question is y is equal to cos inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square minus 1 less than x less than 1. See, for inverse trigonometrical differentiation, you should be knowing the standard results as well as the conditions on inverse trigonometry. Then only you can proceed with the question. If I see this, if I correlate it with some standard form, I see 2x upon 1 plus x square is telling this expression. 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So in place of x, I substitute tan theta. If in place of x, I get tan theta, that means the question converts to cos inverse 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, which gets converted to sine 2 theta, That means this gives me cos inverse sine 2 theta. This sine 2 theta, in turn, I can write as cos of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. Now, again, the restriction that pi by 2 minus 2 theta should lie in between 0 and pi. So, let me cross check it. It says minus 1 is less than x. In place of x, you have substituted tan theta. So this I am getting, this means theta is in between minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. Multiplying it with minus 2 gives me, if I multiply it with minus 2, the sign of inequality changes because it is a negative quantity. This gives me pi by 2 is greater than minus 2 theta is greater than minus pi by 2, which in turn I am writing as minus pi by 2 less than minus 2 theta is less than pi by 2. Again, I have to get the restriction for pi by 2 minus 2 theta. So, I am adding pi by 2 to all the three expressions. Adding pi by 2. If I add pi by 2, I get pi by 2 plus pi by 2 means 0 is less than pi by 2 minus 2 theta is less than pi. So, pi by 2 minus 2 theta is very well in between 0 and pi. It is satisfying this restriction. So I can write the expression as pi by 2 minus 2 theta. This can be written as, that means in turn I can write it as minus 2 theta was tan inverse x. So dy by dx gives me pi by 2's derivative is 0, minus 2 as it is, tan inverse x derivative is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Is equal to tan inverse 3x minus x cube upon 1 minus 3x square, and within this restriction. So as you can very easily see that this expression gets correlated with this one. So in place of x, I will substitute tan theta. If in place of x, I substitute tan theta, I get the expression as y is equal to tan inverse 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus 3 tan square theta. This in turn gives me tan inverse tan 3 theta. Now this 3 theta should be in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So let us check. If tan theta is in between minus 1 by root 3 to root 3, 1 by root 3, this implies theta is in between 1 by root 3 means 30 degrees, that means pi by 6, 2 minus pi by 6, but I want for 3 theta, I'm multiplying it with 3. If I multiply it with 3, I get minus pi by 2 is less than 3 theta is less than pi by 2. So 3 theta satisfies this restriction. So I can write the expression as 3 theta. This is equal to 3 theta, which in turn can be written as tan inverse x. Now the derivative dy by dx is equal to 3 as it is and 1 upon 1 plus x squared. Minus 2x square, I see it get correlated with 1 minus 2 sine square theta. So in place of x, I'm substituting sine theta. This I get as cos inverse 1 minus 2 sine square theta, which gives me cos 2 theta. So I get cos 2 theta, which in turn gives me y is equal to 2 theta. This is equal to 2 sine inverse x. Now the derivative dy by dx is equal to 2 as it is. Derivative of sine inverse x is 1 upon root 1 minus x square. If I have y is equal to sine inverse 2 raised to the power x plus 1 upon 1 plus 4 raised to the power x. If I see carefully, this gets correlated with this result. As you can see that this expression can be written as 2 into 2 raised to the power x. The bases are same, powers get added. So I can write it as 1 plus x because x plus 1 is given. As well as 4 raised to the power x can be written as 2 square the power x. That means this can be written as 2 raised to the power x square. So that means this expression I will write as 2 raised to the power x square. So if you see this carefully, this is 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So I am going to substitute 2 raised to the power x as tan theta. So this comes out as sine inverse 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, which is the standard result for sine 2 theta. So y is equal to sine inverse sine 2 theta, which in turn gives me 2 theta, which in turn gives me 2 tan inverse 2 raised to the power x. Now for differentiation, we have to apply chain rule to it. Dy by dx is 2 as it is, tan inverse derivative is 1 upon 1 plus 2 raised to the power x square. Tan inverse rule is over. Now it is 2 raised to the power x. 2 raised to the power x, we have to apply a raised to the power x rule. Derivative of a raised to the power x is a raised to the power x log a. Therefore, 2 raised to the power x derivative is 2 raised to the power x log 2. So, finally, we get this result. In the next video, I will take the differentiation of inverse trigonometrical functions where the expressions, this type of expressions are not following some standard rule, but different type of substitutions we have to do.